go tell the weatherman. I said, I want it sunny outside. It ain't no darkness into my motions. So tired of living in yesterday.
Sup, what it does do. Good morning. The dental room shares a block with the OTs and physios, so the other comms are always a shout away. Sometimes they hear our patients screaming, and we hear theirs. The benches can become loaded with patients where you can see up to 60 a day. My maximum so far is 70. The biggest challenge I've had so far with patients is the language barrier. The vast majority only speak Zulu and can't read or write. They depend on us to fill in the consent forms for them. So I've had to struggle through reading a language I don't know to get the patient to understand and give consent. Luckily, most of the time, my colleagues can assist me with that. I learned the Zulu necessities for dentistry within 2 weeks and can communicate effectively now. 95% of the patients we see get extractions. In rural clinics and hospitals, it's rare to have the facilities and tools to do things like endos. We don't have intraoral or pan machines. If the patient has pain, especially when they sleep, then the tooth has to come out. Otherwise, they'll attempt to remove it themselves. This also makes up a lot of what comes in. Rural ComServe made me realize that learning to extract at uni is like getting a driver's license. Sure, you can drive, but definitely not well. So don't stress, after 2 weeks of this, you'll be extracting 30 teeth before lunch without breaking a sweat. We get some time where there aren't any patients outside. I then become a man of culture and deep dive into a book, listen to a podcast, or play my favorite, Stardew Valley. So I'm quite lucky. We have 3 dental chairs, and the 2 in front are mainly used for extractions. This is what the dental room looks like. It's quite spacious and nice to work in when the chairs are working. I was super stressed when I started out, and I wasn't sure if I was good enough or new enough to be ready to treat independently. Relax, you'll be fine. The knowledge I gained at uni made me deal with every situation that came my way comfortably. And I definitely wasn't the best or brightest student. I was not a cum laude student, I was a cum pass student. The system here works like this. You give the patients outside consent forms, they fill them in, or you help them when it's their turn, quickly scan through their form of health issues, then they go hlala, which is sit. You then ask them which tooth hurts, kumbai zinyo ali bushlung. They point, you percuss, send them outside, and then repeat the process. At any one time, you can have 10 people injected outside, you then bring them in one for one and extract. How busy you'll be depends on patients. But also that some places are different, as I've heard from colleagues, that they go to work at 8 and finish at 12. Me, 7:45 to 4:30 every day.
Oh, that's rude. You're on candid camera, son.
It's about drive, it's about power. We stay hungry, we devour. Put in the work, put in the hours, and take what's ours. Like in some morning in my veins, my culture banging with strange. I change the game, so what's my name?
Hi guys. So I just finished up with work, and government's nice because 4:30 you just leave, but it's great. So luckily I live like 3 minutes from where I work, because in most of the places, especially if you're rural, you're gonna stay in the the doctor's quarters or the quarters on the hospital premises, so it's quite nice. Sometimes you have security and everything. So luckily I live in a house, which is great. And it's a three-person house, but at the moment I don't have roommates. I was supposed to have, but they just either never showed up at the hospital, or the ones they assigned me got moved in somewhere else. So it happens. Maybe someone moves in here later in the year. But yeah, for now I'll just show you what the place looks like. So walking in from the front door, this is a spacious living room. This is remnants from last year's group. They built a bar, which is quite impressive. And then like, there's the corridor, and we have our own kitchen. Well, I have my own kitchen. And then bedrooms and bathrooms. Got a shower, bath, everything. All at the moment, everything's to me. And then my room is quite spacious. I'm lucky enough to be working at a hospital and not a clinic. So the opportunity to see some crazy stuff is much higher. As the dentist, you get referrals from other wards. So before lunchtime today, I got called in to go see a patient in high care. I just did a consult with her and had to give my opinion on the situation. But then this afternoon, I had to go into male ward as the patient got shot and is paraplegic, so they couldn't make it into our ward, into the dental ward. He had to have a tooth extracted in the male medical ward. And sometimes you're going to have to perform in front of the other people and the other patients. It happens. So, but now that I'm off, I just plan on making dinner. And then I can phone the queen of dentistry at Tux and of my heart, Tamsin McKenzie. And then I'm just going to chill, eat, and just enjoy my evening. A lot of ComServe is just chilling and doing what makes you happy. Don't let anyone tell you different. So we just hit a lull period at work where there aren't any patients at the moment. They'd normally be sitting out the bench out front, so we'd see them coming half and they come knock. So today's Wednesday. Today's generally the theatre day. So sometimes you go into theatre, the patient would be put under general anaesthesia. And then, for example, it's in special cases where there are children that are extremely uncooperative, or we get a lot of cerebral palsy children here. Where we had to do that last week and see a cerebral palsy child because they physically can't open for you, or they don't understand what you're trying to do or trying to help them. So, but today we didn't have any theatre cases, unfortunately, but luckily working at a hospital, you do have opportunities to see things like that. Where today, we had two patients coming in. So the one child had impacted canines. He was 11 years old. He had all his permanent teeth from 6 to 6. However, the canines were sitting very high up. So then with my recommendation, and I spoke to the parents, I was like, if we extract the fours, then it'll make space for the canines to come down, because we can't really refer them to Durban for braces, and they also can't afford the transport and to do it. And that's how it goes here in the rural areas. So you need to make a plan. And yeah, it's where university knowledge kicks in. So that's what happened today. So we have our very own pastry chef, Damien, who worked in a Michelin star restaurant.
Luckily for me, everything is a short walk from where I live. It was at my first meeting where one of the permanent doctors looked at my long pants and long socks with shirts under my scrubs and said, "Dude, read the vibe, short pants and sandals only." So welcome to Manguzi, where the temperature is an average of 28 with an 83% humidity. Okay, so I'll be driving through the hospital premises. Just had to go pick up the pizza from the resident baker. It's gonna be amazing. Man is the best person ever. So yeah, there's houses and hospital residents, and everyone just lives here on the hospital grounds. So I think it's gonna be bumpy. Yes. Good.
Beautiful rainy day, and the feet of you, smooth it.
So I know everyone's been wondering, Herman, what do you do in your free time? What do you do when there's nothing to do? So we've seen Kiash, excellent musician, makes music in his spare time. We've seen Jim, party animal, has fun in his spare time. We've seen Dr. Yasin Khamuldin, photographer. Now it's my turn. So here's my baby.
I am a gamer.
That's what I like to do. It's for my hobby, it's what I do for fun. So on weekends, sometimes we get invited out to do stuff. Sometimes we plan to do things like go to the beach, go to some of the local lodges. But there are some times where work ties me out or where I'm just not in the mood to see people. I'm a bit of an introvert sometimes. So then I just like to kick back and just spend a lot of my weekend just gaming. It's what makes me happy. And in your conserve, you need to do what makes you happy. Don't let anyone tell you different. Don't feel peer pressured to do other things. Do what makes you happy. It's your year. It's pretty much mostly a gap year. So enjoy it while you can, because after that work gets real and work gets hard. Now you're just chilling and having a good time.